you spend 2 years at college, and the first year you do your NC qualification, and then the second year you do your HNC in your chosen discipline, which for me would be instrumentation.
So in your first year you get an NC in a mixed multidiscipline of engineering, and to get that you do like learning outcomes. So for each lesson you'll have between 4 and 6 learning outcomes, and as you've completed your first one you'll do an exam, then you'll complete your second one and do an exam, and that's how the process of exams would work. And for your higher national certificate, it's in your discipline that you've chosen, so mine's process.
College learning is split up into two parts really. You've got your practical, hands-on training, and then you've got your classroom-based training.
So the combination on the apprenticeship of both classroom work and the workshop work is you learn the sort of theory behind what you're doing in the classroom. I do it at the beginning of the week, and then by the end of the week I come into the workshop and we get taught how to do it practically. And the understanding that the classroom work gives you compared to the practical go like hand in hand.
Every 3 months we meet up with OGTAP, who ensure that we're enjoying the course, and if we have any issues we make sure that they flatten them out and make sure that we're all enjoying everything. And if there's ever a problem, we know that we can just go and speak to them and they can make sure that it's sorted.
By the end of your 4-year apprenticeship, you have a Scottish vocational qualification. So your SVQ is a globally recognised qualification that enables you to travel across the world to work offshore, not just in the North Sea.
All the qualifications form part of the modern apprenticeship. Since it's such a globally recognised award, it really keeps my options open for the future.
The course is becoming a little bit more challenging. Obviously it's becoming more focused as we move on. You just need to make sure that you balance your time out right and that you study the correct amount. Everyone's always obviously looking forward to finishing your 2 years at your college, but you're not going to get there if you don't study and make the time for it.
When you go home, there's still lots of work you have to do, so there'll be assignments or homework you have to catch up on, especially like online. So we use a program called Blackboard, which they even update in the holidays.
To get offshore, there's two courses which are mandatory, which is your MIST and your BOSIAT.
Your BOSIAT's done at least about 2 weeks before you finally go offshore, and that's just after your first 2 years.
So your MIST is your minimum industry safety training, and that just covers basics. Things which I now take for granted, just do's and don'ts and correct procedures, and it'll go into some terminology that's used offshore just to give you a heads up. And your BOSIAT, which is your survival training, that was my favourite part, it was class.
What stands out for me the most from college was a great learning experience. You're also paid to learn, so that was another benefit. I've made friends for life who will be doing the same career path as me, so all in all it was very good.